Touchdown. Welcome to 100 Yards of Sports. Today is our NFL Draft Edition. The four teams we're going to preview today are going to be the New York Giants, the G-Man, the Chicago Bears, my father's favorite team, the Oakland Raiders with the silver and black, and the Houston Texans. Join me today as my co-host and my partner in crime. He's with me every week, Mr. Barry Brown of the Student Athlete Playbook. How you doing, Coach Brown?
Hey, man, I'm doing wonderful.
You ready to talk some football?
Ah, you already know.
And today we got a special guest who's going to be joining us, the gentleman, 1990 national champion with the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets, safety consensus All-American. That means he made every All-American team that year.
Hands down. My
man, Kenneth Swilling, joining us today.
Hey, what's up, man? Everything
good?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Turner, how you doing, sir?
How you doing, sir?
Oh, man, you know.
All right. You doing all right?
Yeah, I'm doing pretty good.
What you doing these days?
I'm working.
Oh, okay.
And eating, as you can see.
Well, let's get into the today teams. We're going to preview first. We're going to start with the New York Giants. We're going to talk about their draft needs, their top three draft needs, offensive tackle, cornerback, and linebacker. Last year didn't end too well for the Giants. It went 3-13. Ben McAdoo got fired, the head coach. Jerry Reese got fired, the GM. So now they got a new GM and a new head coach, Pat Shurmur and David Gentleman. David Gentleman coming over from the Carolina Panthers.
Yes, right.
So now the G-Man have a new look. They got a second pick in this year's draft. Mm-hmm. And remember this, the last time they had the second pick was in 1981, and they got that young man out of Williamsburg, Virginia. Mm-hmm. And he put the league on fire. Went by the initials LT. And we know how the Giants turned out. They got two Super Bowls under them in 1986 and 1990. Right. So to me, they got a critical part in the draft. Mm-hmm. Looking what they needed, the offensive tackle, they got that sold up. They signed Nate Solder, brought him over from New England.
Yes.
When you look at the cornerback position, they cut Dominique Rogers Kamadi. Mm-hmm. He wanted too much money.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So now you're looking at them probably taking the defensive back. Not high, though, but they did bring back Eli Apple, who I think is a very nice talent. Mm-hmm. And then finally they need a linebacker. They went out and traded for Alex Ogletree, former Georgia linebacker. Mm-hmm. So my thinking is if they still stay with the number two pick, because rumors are they're thinking about trading the pick to the Buffalo Bills and picking up the Bills' two picks at 12 and 22. But when you look at all over, I think it's going to be a new regime in New York. If they stay pat with the number two pick, the rumors is they won't sell Saquon Barkley. Mm-hmm. But I don't think that's going to happen because I think – the quarterback, I think Barkley is going to be gone. I think the Cleveland Browns are going to take him number one. But when you look at the Giants, my thinking to be a small organization, I would trade the pick and pick up two extra picks in the first round. Because when you look at it, I don't think they're really that far from a football team and being back, being competitive. It still got one of the best defensive lines in the game. Jason Pierre-Paul, Damian Harrison, Oliver Vernon. They kind of showed up their defense now with Alex Ogletree. They still got the best safety in the game, the young men out of New Orleans.
Lando Collins
right. is still playing at a high level. Mm-hmm. So to me, I would trade out of the pick, move down, take the two best available players for 12 and 22 and set pat. Mm-hmm. And I think when you talk about everybody talking about the Giants need a quarterback, mm-hmm. I still – like Coach Brown has mentioned a couple weeks ago, I still like the young man out of Cal, Davis Webb, that they took last year in the third round. So I think they need to groom him instead of talking about getting a quarterback. But I know that y'all gentlemen don't like it. This Eli's still going to be there, and y'all don't too much like Eli Manning.
Oh, you're talking about Coach Brown. I like Eli. Coach Brown doesn't care for Eli too much, but I like Eli. I like what he brings to the table. I think he still has another good two or three years left in him.
Yes,
however,
sir.
I think this is an opportunity, even at the number two pick, for them, for the New York Giants to go ahead and get his replacement ready. I mean, I know you mentioned Davis Webb. I'm not convinced that he's the guy that's going to do it. This is a draft that you can kind of get that guy and kind of set it in motion. You mentioned some things that I agree with you. They could trade down and move down into the draft and pick up two other picks. However, this is the moment when they can kind of change their franchise and set their franchise up for the future, I believe. I don't see them getting Saquon Barkley. I don't see how Cleveland would allow that to happen.
and before I move to Coach Brown right quick, so what you're saying is that one of the quarterbacks out there, you like Sam Donald, Josh Rosen, or Josh Allen. You like or either Baker Mayfield.
I like Josh Allen out of all of them. I like him. I like him the best. I think he has the best arm talent out of all of them.
Wow. Wait a minute. So now, you hear these comments these gentlemen are making, Mr. Football, Ken Swilling. Listen, if you like what you're hearing or dislike what you're hearing, comment on the page, like the page, and then share the page. Because remember, we are 100 Yards of Sports, the most informative, community-based, and entertaining sports talk show on the planet. Now, Mr. Football, Ken Swilling, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. But listen, the Giants, they better not move down. I would recommend Giant fans, y'all might want to write in, call in to the Giants headquarters and let them know, keep the number two pick. If the Browns make some of the craziest decisions they've made in the past, they might just pick a quarterback and leave Saquon Barkley for you. So I will wait and keep my number two pick just for that reason. Then, if they do take Saquon Barkley, then you go ahead and do what Ken Swilling said. You take whatever quarterback you have graded out the highest, which personally I think would be Sam Darnold for them. Let him sit a year or two. Even though I'm not a big Eli Manning fan, they're going to start Eli for the next couple of years, at least two probably, and then get your next quarterback ready, which I would recommend them getting. And I think it's on their radar to get Sam Darnold, if depending on what the Browns do.
We're going to move on to the Chicago Bears. The monsters of the Midway. They haven't been the monsters of the Midway in a while.
For a long time.
They coach got fired.
Yes, sir.
And they ended up bringing in Matt Nagy.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Offensive coordinator from the Kansas City Chiefs, a disciple of Andy Reid. A guy that's got a lot of offensive proudness. I tell you what, I like the quarterback Mitch Trubisky. I thought he played real well under certain circumstances.
Wow.
They top three needs for the draft is wide receiver, cornerback, and offensive tackle. Mm-hmm. Well, they went out and I think saw the need getting the wide receiver, getting Allen Robinson out of Jacksonville. Mm-hmm. Young man, he's still 24 years old. He didn't play last year, tore his knee up in training camp. But if you look what Mr. Robinson did back in 2015, 96 receptions, over 1,400 yards, a very, very explosive football player. Then you look into the Bears overall. The offensive line is going to come back, whether or not Kyle Long is healthy. Defensively, I like what they did last year. As I told you, I thought Eddie Jackson out of the University of Alabama, I thought he was one of the best young defensive players in the league. So I'm liking what the Bears are doing. They got Allen Robinson. To me, the key is defensively, they bring back a pretty good defense. Akeem Hicks, to me, was one of the best defensive linemen, maybe the best defensive lineman in the league.
I agree with that. I like Akeem Hicks. They did a good job, I think, re-signing, even though some of their fans didn't agree with it, but they re-signed Kyle Fuller, brought him back in the secondary. So that solidifies them on the back end of their defense. You know, I think they offensively, like, I agree with you, they need wide receiver help. They brought in Taylor Gabriel. They got Taylor Gabriel off free agency. Mm-hmm. So that should help a little bit. You know, I'd like to see them go ahead and do some other things to kind of help them on the offensive side of the ball. Defensively, they can play with anybody.
They bring in Kyle Fuller back, but think about this. With the ninth pick, with the eighth pick in the draft, a lot of people saying they're going to take their young man out of the Ohio State, Denzel Ward, who was the best defensive back in the draft.
Right.
Like I predicted with Marshawn Lattimore last year, the best cover guy. Now you put him with Kyle Fuller. Now you're thinking about you got two quality corners. And think about this. You in the NFC North and you're playing against Twinkle Toes. That's his nickname, Mr. Aaron Rodgers over there in Green Bay. Coach Brown, the Bears?
Man, before we go to the next team, only thing I'm going to say about the Bears is if they're believing in Trubisky, they made a terrible mistake there.
Wow.
So I do not believe in that young man. So they're going to need their defense to save them this season. So actually, I would go, instead of Denzel Ward, I would look at a man we mentioned before, early in previous shows, I would go with Tremaine Edmonds out of Virginia Tech as my number one pick for the Chicago Bears.
And before we move on to our final team today, which is going to be the Oakland Raiders, I'm going to say this because this is my father's team.
Yes, sir.
I think a lot with Mr. Trubisky, I think you hard, but remember they still got Jordan Howard, who's quietly put up 2,500 yards, and Jordan Howard comes out of, Dad, this is for you. He comes out of that great line of the Chicago Bear running backs, Willie Gallimore. the great Walter Payton, okay. Neil Anderson, and Matt Forte. Remember that now.
I will remember
Mr.
that.
Mr. Trubisky got Jordan Howard.
I will remember
now
that.
Now let's go to the silver and black, the Oakland Raiders.
Yes,
the most disappointing team in football last year in the AFC.
Yeah.
You ended up giving Derek Carr all that money. 120,
yes.
What was it? Outrageous
about
number.
$128
million. Yeah,
over 5 years.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
You saw what happened there. He got Jack Del Rio fired. And I mean fired, like fired the Ohio players.
Right.
But at the end of the day, this is an Oakland Raiders team that's not far off. Mm-hmm. John Gruden takes over the reins now. They did some interesting things in free agency, but to me, they need a defensive lineman or impact defensive player. Now, Coach Brown, you picked the player I think could take mm-hmm. Khalil Mack's game to another level, and Bruce Irvin. Can you imagine Tremaine Edmonds with Khalil Mack and Bruce Irvin?
I like that.
And then if Mario Edwards is healthy. Right.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I like that.
Now you're thinking about them Oakland Raiders defensive lines back in the day. They had John Matuszak,
right.
Howie Long,
right.
Greg
right.
Townsend, and Psycho himself, Lyle Alzado.
He's a psycho man.
I'm just saying. You talking about the Raiders being back to silver and black, being a real physical football team.
Well, what you see going on, what I like what they did with their trades and actually what they've done as far as draft picks, they picked up 11 draft picks in this draft. So they can go out and pretty much get everything they need. So I'm looking for them, actually, with their first pick, I like them going to see getting the right receiver. I know they picked up some.
Jordy Nelson.
So that's a great safety blanket for Carr. So now I see them going out and looking at that right receiver, James Washington from Oklahoma State. Don't be surprised if they go with him with their first pick.
And that concludes today's NFL segment here on 100 Yards of Sports. Kudos to the New York Giants, Eli Manning. Kudos to the Chicago Bears, my father's favorite team. Walter Payton, you rest in peace. I love you. And kudos to the Oakland Raiders and Silver and Black. You paid David Carr too much money. Derek Carr too much money. But we'll be back here next week. The team on the rise, and then we're going to preview, is going to be the Houston Texans. Mm. Well, my man out of Gainesville, Georgia, Mr. Deshaun Watson.
Yeah.
We'd like to say thank you. God bless. Have a wonderful weekend. Be safe if you're going out there and watching any NCAA tournament games in the South Regional. I'm Vincent Turner. My man, Mr. Ken Swilling, Georgia Tech royalty,
yes, sir.
And the man of the hour, he always got to kill Eli, Barry Bryant, Leon, the Atlanta voice.